Greetings from Lancaster Catholic High School. I hope these early days of summer find you and your family safe and well. This is the second in our five-part series of videos to let you know exactly what our plans are for the opening of school this August, given the unprecedented challenges we face due to the COVID epidemic. I'm going to explain the details of our planning so far and review for you the areas that we're focusing on in our planning. One example of the safety precautions that we're going to require everyone to take when they come to school in August, faculty and students alike, is this face shield. The face shield blocks the spread of COVID in an effective way, but it also allows the students to see teachers and hear teachers using the microphone that will be accompanying this face shield, so the teachers can see their students and students can see their teacher's face as they're delivering instruction. We're going to run down the state of our planning to date. And again, this is the second video in a five-part series that will come out about every 2 weeks, detailing all of our plans to make sure that we open the 2021 school year with maximum safety for everyone. To review, we are preparing to be able to offer our educational program in any of three modes: the in-person, hybrid, and virtual models. To meet the challenges we face as the result of the coronavirus pandemic and the related restrictions, we're developing specific plans in five specific domains. Here are the specific policies and procedures we have developed so far in each of the domains. In the domain of logistics and planning, all who enter the building will pass through thermal temperature scanners. If the temperature exceeds 100.4 degrees, which is the CDC threshold, that individual will be scanned with a head thermometer. If the temperature reading is confirmed, the individual will be sent home and required to seek medical attention and not be able to return to school until cleared by a physician.
This is our plug into a cell phone thermal camera we call Compact.
Bill Parrish has been in the thermal imaging business for 45 years.
This gets cut up into little die.
His company, Seek Thermal, is a top supplier to firefighters.
Thermal imaging has another very particularly interesting feature that's very important for firefighters: it sees through smoke.
These days, he's preparing to battle one of the biggest invisible enemies we've seen, COVID-19.
We can't say you've got COVID, but we can say, you know, it looks like you have an elevated temperature.
The company has developed a contactless temperature screening system called Seek Scan.
Thermal imaging is the ability to see heat, basically.
It took some creative engineering to make this system fast and accurate.
Thermal cameras like this are really good at detecting relative temperature differences from a distance. What this camera is doing is comparing my skin's temperature to this reference point behind me.
If it's higher than the threshold, the system sounds an alarm for further screening.
The warmer you are, the more light you give off. You certainly don't want somebody coming to work that's sick.
And although my temperature seems lower than normal, that's because I got a peek at beta software. The final version will convert a skin temperature reading into an estimated body temperature reading. An operator is optional, but even then, the entire process takes social distancing into consideration. With millions of businesses poised to implement temperature-taking technology for employees and perhaps even customers, Bill has a new concern.
We're going to have a struggle to meet the demand.
Classrooms will be configured to respect 6 feet of separation between students whenever possible. And in all cases, either face masks or face shields, like the one I demonstrated at the beginning of this video, must be worn by teachers and students. Staggering students at class dismissal times and increased faculty monitoring in the hallways will be how we maintain social distancing in community areas like locker rooms and restrooms, the lunchroom and cafeteria, and the library. For example, specific seating will be marked in the cafeteria at lunches and for study halls. Monitoring the number of students in and out of the classrooms for personal needs, such as going to the lavatory breaks, will be standard operating procedure. Upon arrival in the morning, all students will immediately go to lockers and then to homeroom. There'll be no gathering in spaces like the hallway or the cafeteria. Attendance at mass or liturgies or assemblies will be required, but will be viewed from homerooms and live streams to all the classrooms rather than in a single gathering in the gym. The school will be actively engaged in the hybrid model or blended learning whenever necessary. Students will be able to participate live and access their schedule from a remote location like home. This option will be available to students who may need it at any time during the school year, whether or not the entire school is in the hybrid or in-person model. The full list of supplies and cleaning materials will be available on the website throughout the summer and during the school year. We've created a detailed, specific plan for deep cleaning all facilities and high-touch areas multiple times during the day. Individuals will be required to wear protective masks or face shields or learn from home or a remote location at any time during the school year. As I said earlier, the option will be provided for students and families who need it to allow students to access the entire educational program in real time at home, whether or not the entire school is in the in-person or hybrid model. One of the things that we've been working on all summer is to create a plan to facilitate meaningful instruction in any of these three modes. As a result, Catholic High is currently rewriting our entire curriculum and diversifying an instruction and assessment strategies to make sure that we're equipped for face-to-face, hybrid, and remote learning. The use of technology has been an integral part of our curriculum for the past 8 years and will continue. That's what allowed us to seamlessly transition during the spring to the virtual learning environment. And finally, one of the major areas of preparation is the domain of technology. Equipping each and every classroom to be able to deliver every class offered on a daily basis, whether students are in person in the classroom or at home in real time on any given day, is an expensive proposition. We have ordered and procured the equipment to make sure that every single classroom at Lancaster Catholic High School is equipped to allow for in-person, virtual, and hybrid learning, that is, where some students are in front of the teacher as usual in the classroom, while others are at home experiencing the class in real time. Every classroom will be equipped with the necessary equipment, including monitors for students at home to be able to see the teacher and be seen by the teacher, microphones capable of picking up what the teacher's instructions are, as well as all classroom discussion, and of course the ability to project whatever the teacher is projecting on their blackboard, which in this case will be a smart board, to the students in the classrooms simultaneously with those at home. Our reopening plan continues to be developed. And as we've said all along, the pandemic is often a moving target, and therefore guidance from the state and diocese continues to be fluid. Stay tuned for the remainder of the summer. We'll send the next videos with updates on our plans about every 2 weeks. Our goal is to give you as much details of the further steps that we're taking to prepare for a safe opening of school for everyone at Lancaster Catholic High School in August. I remind you to regularly consult our website, and for those of you who are fall athletes, please make sure that you're in touch with Rich Hinnenkamp, our athletic director, for instructions as we reconvene. Our athletic teams for the fall have already started workouts, and please make sure that you follow that information very closely. Until next time, from all of us at Lancaster Catholic High School, I wish you and your family a safe and peaceful summer. Please pray for us as we continue to pray for you, and may God bless you.